Hello, I'm Lord Davidson, servant and apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ in Dallas, Fort Worth, Texas, and sent by God to your house to declare to you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15, 3 and 4 tell us what the gospel is, how that Jesus died for our sins. According to Scripture, he was buried. He rose again the third day according to the Scripture. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he's anointed me, preach the gospel to the poor, sent me to heal the brokenhearted, preach deliverance to the captives, recovering of sight to the blind, and set at liberty them that are bruised. The word is nigh thee, even in my heart, in my mouth, is the word of faith which I preach. You will confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God hath raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. With the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. It is the power of God unto salvation. Everyone that believeth, the Jew first, and also to the Greek. Therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by his faith. I want to welcome everyone throughout the world, wherever you're located, and receiving this message by live stream, Roku, or other devices. Welcome. Have on the set with me Terry Brown. Good morning, Terry.
Good morning, Doyle.
And how are you?
I'm well, thank you.
Very good. You're going to start reading for us.
Yes.
In Romans chapter 8, right?
Right.
I'll just let you read and read as far as the Lord leads you.
All right.
All right?
Romans 8, verse 1. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus hath made me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh, God sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh and for sin, condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace, because the carnal mind is enmity against God. For it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So then, they that are in the flesh cannot please God.
That it?
I think that's it.
Very good.
Since that's our topic.
For many years, I've been walking just that way. It took me about 10 to learn how to walk with the Lord in the Spirit. Him corrected me all that time from 1970 to 1980, and then I came to Plano. Something happened to you in 07, I think.
Yes.
I made a phone call to you, mm-hmm. and you remembered a lot better than I do, for certain. That would you like to share what happened that day, and then what happened subsequently after that?
Huh? All right. Well, in 07, it was January 2nd of 07, you gave me a phone call and you said, Terry, I've been praying, and for several days the Lord has been convincing me that you are a prophetess to lead the women in the dance. And you told me on the phone, and then you posted it on your website on the news of interest.
Good.
I kept a copy of that.
Okay.
It was remarkable to me. I was delighted for God's call all my life, I was delighted that God wanted to do something, that he would do something with me. I also took note of you saying it took several days for God to convince you. So, but that's normal. You try the spirit of things that come to your heart. You don't just speak the first thing, and you prove them by the spirit. But I had been working for over 10 years, and through the years, I have to set 07 up a little bit. Yeah. I have to back up a little bit to set it up. Because in the years of working, my heart got bogged down a lot with the world. There were still things in me. I'd had deliverance through the years. I committed myself to the gospel in many ways, but there were still things in my heart. And in certain situations, my heart was bogged down with the world. I had some love of the world in me, as every human being does. Amen. And I hadn't overcome it all. But in April 06, now God told you to deliver me in September of 1992. Correct. And you prayed for me off and on throughout the years, sometimes maybe once a week for several months, sometimes not at all for a while, just however the Lord led you. And I had a lot of deliverance during those years. But in April 06, one Monday morning, you called and asked me if I would come up for prayer. And you prayed a couple of hours that day, and I had much deliverance from witchcraft. And at the end of that, you said, "This is God. Can you come back tomorrow? We're going to pray some more." Well, it turned out, neither of us knew at the outset, but it turned out that you prayed 9 days. It was Monday through Saturday, then we had Sunday church day, then Monday through Wednesday. So those 9 days, Monday through Saturday, Monday through Wednesday, you prayed hour and a half to 2 hours all of those days. And I had much deliverance from witchcraft. And I did not see immediately, like the month following, I couldn't say, "Oh, wow, everything has really changed." But you also exhorted me at the time that I would need to do much more reading than I had been doing. Now, I was working full-time, had 4 children, not all of them at home, but it was a busy, very busy life. But I did spend more time reading. And in the fall, there was a major miracle that God did for me because I believed the gospel. I was working full-time, and I had accepted just a 3-month project I was going to work on in the evenings. And then in November of 06, we began worshiping every night in the fellowship hall. And the first night it started, you said, "This is God. We're going to worship every night." Well, when that happened, now I've shared this before, so I'm not going to go into a lot of detail about this testimony. But when that happened, there was a commitment within me that I did not want to miss a night of worship. And I did not know how I could do this other little job in the evenings and come to worship. And I said, "Well, one thing I know, the gospel is salvation. Then if I will believe the gospel, there will be salvation through that situation, that job." And it ended up, after a few weeks, the company called up and completely changed the scope of the job. It was actually SEC requirements. I do not know to this day what happened, except God delivered me out. But when you called up then January 2nd of 07, had moved in here, the sanctuary, sometime in early January to begin live streaming the worship every night. Amen. And when you called and you said that God had convinced you that I was a prophetess, one of my early thoughts was I was kind of amazed because I knew I had been bogged down with the world. And I knew I didn't like it all, but I also, God had to deliver me out of it. It had to be a path of God to deliver me out. But I thought, how wonderful this call of God on my life. And I wanted to be faithful to the call. I wanted to be faithful and walk wholeheartedly before God. And there was just a commitment in me. It was like a zeal, like a hunger, a thirst, that just almost an insatiable drive. I was thinking on this morning, and it came to my heart, the scripture about taking every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. That's what it was. That's what that anointing that came with being anointed prophetess, that's what came into my heart. And so I just sought with everything in me to order my life, to take captive every thought to the obedience of Christ. Work, my children, my house, everything that I did. Now, working full time, I just took every task and committed it to the Lord and sought to obey God in the way that I did everything. Right around that time, I'll put this in, right around that time, Steve came home one day and said, well, I've signed us up for the cruise this year. We had been on cruises three years in a row. It was their annual company convention that he was required to go on, and they liked for spouses to attend. But this year, with the worship and with this anointing in my heart, I did not want to miss one night of worship. Now, this was not a legal thing. This was the yearning of my heart. I did not want to miss one night of worship. And Jesus put it in me as if it was like my personal appointment with him. And I know you can come to Jesus anytime, day or night, and he lives in my heart. But this was a means for me to overcome worshiping every night and put off things of the flesh. You know, this verse as we read, verse 6 says, for to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace, because the carnal mind is enmity against God. Anything in your life, in my life, I'm talking about myself, anything in my life that was carnal was an enemy against God. A carnal mind, a mind that has involvements in the world, is an enmity of God. And in the flesh, verse 8, them that are in the flesh cannot please God. And I wanted to overcome the flesh in my life. You know, in Corinthians, I believe it's 2 Corinthians 6, it says, talks about cleansing yourself of all filthiness of the flesh and the spirit.
7.
Thank you. 2 Corinthians 7, 1. Right. Also, one more verse in Colossians. I want to read this. It says, Colossians 3, if you then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affection, that word is mind, your thinking. Set your affection, your mind, your thinking on things above, not on things of the earth. And one more I want to read in Philippians chapter 3, in verse 18, it says, many walk, of whom I've told you often, and now tell you even weeping, they are the enemies of the cross of Christ. Now look at this, verse 19, who the enemies of the cross are, whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly, whose glory is in their shame, who mind earthly things.
Amen.
You are an enemy. I am an enemy if I mind earthly things. So I set everything in me, my heart, my will, my soul, my affections, my emotions, my will, my thoughts on seeking the kingdom and walking in the spirit. So Steve came home and said, I've signed us up for the cruise. I said, okay. He walked out of the room. I walked into my closet and I said, well, Jesus, what do you think about that? I commit this to you. You know, I do not want to go. I do not want to miss one night of worship. And I commit this to the judge of the whole earth who will do right. We'll see what you think about this. Well, I went on for a couple of months, coming every night, worshiping God with everything in me, praising and worshiping God. This is January, February, March of 07. I began to have pains in my feet, in my legs, in my knees, in my ankles, in my toes, in the tendons, in the muscles, in the bones, in the ligaments. I would have one pain in one place, get through it, and have a pain in the other leg. Get through it, have a pain in the other knee. Get through that, have a pain. Some would last days, some would go weeks. Some were excruciating. This went on for about a year and a half. And do you know what I was doing? I was overcoming the flesh. I was overcoming the sin of the world.
Amen.
When you mind the things of the flesh, it's sin. I mean, there's only God and the flesh. Whatsoever's not faith is sin.
Amen.
And, you know, you just have to look at yourself real honest and square and say, whatever is not of faith of the Spirit of God, it's sin. Just don't sugarcoat it.
Amen.
And I fought. It's in Matthew, Jesus said, the kingdom of God suffereth violence, and the violence take it by force.
Oh.
And I was determined to take the kingdom of God. And Jesus said, he told us, seek the kingdom. Seek the kingdom of God, and all things will be added to you. He also said, you know what? I was after the kingdom, and I knew I was going to get it. I knew it.
Amen.
You know why? Jesus said, fear not, little flock. It's the Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. So you seek something Jesus tells you to seek, and he says it's the Father's good pleasure to give it to you. Well, you know what? I knew I was going to get it, but I had to fight for it. I had to fight every day. So here I am at work, busy all day long, a very detailed oriented job. I was in accounting. So I'm seeking to submit every thought, every task to the Lord, to the minding the things of the Spirit. And one day, here's just a little example. I'm doing the bank rec, and I go along a couple of hours. It was very intense, very detailed. After a couple of hours, I'm like, oh, shoot. I went all that time and didn't even think of the Lord. And this happened a number of times. And one day I said, you know what? God has given me this job. I'm obeying God, doing this job. And if I have to concentrate for a period of time to do this job in obedience to God, then so be it. I'm still obeying God, and I'm not in the flesh. I'm obeying God.
Amen.
And you know what? That was faith. That
Amen.
Was faith that rose up in me. And I said, I am obeying God in this job, and everything I do is obeying God, and I will not yield to doubt and unbelief that I've gotten off in the flesh. If I'm obeying God, I'm following the Spirit of God, and I'm obeying God. Well, you know what happened after that is that his thoughts were in me more and more and more. They came more often and more often. And those details, even in those details, the thoughts of the Lord were not as far between. You see, faith will overcome. This is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. What is that? 1 John something.
Right.
It's in 1 John. This is the victory that overcometh the world. The world that's in your heart, that's in your life, the love of the world in you. The victory that overcomes it is your faith. You walk by faith and you'll overcome that world that's in you. Well, this went on in my job. I overcame more and more, walked in the Spirit with my job. Then Steve came home one day, I don't know, maybe March or early April, and said, well, the cruise has fallen through. There weren't enough people to make this cruise. So they've altered the whole scope of it. Just a couple of staff members went with the few distributors that had signed up. God delivered me out of going on that cruise. Oh, I could have said no. But, you know, In Ephesians 5, it says, wives, submit to your husbands. And a few verses before that, it says, submit you one to another. And I could submit myself and go. And Jesus knew I would. But I submitted to the judge of the whole earth. And he ruled that situation what he wanted. He did not want me to go. And I didn't go. And I was glad to be delivered out of it. One more area I've got to cover is with my children. Well, my family, children and Steve. We would go to lunch after church or whenever we'd go to dinner. And I was seeking for all of my thoughts to be on the kingdom of God, to mind the things of the spirit, not the things of the flesh. The things of the flesh are death. The things of the spirit are life and peace. So I was set to mind the things of the spirit. Well, we'd go to lunch and I'd bring up the things of God, maybe a little 5 minutes discussion, and then it'd dwindle back down to the things of the world, the job, sports, what they were doing, what this or that, shopping, all different things, you know, the things of the world. I'd been there and they were all still there, but I'd bring it back up to things of the Lord. Sometimes I was fighting so hard to mind the things of the spirit. Sometimes I didn't even know what to say. I might tell a scripture I'd read that was good, that I liked. Sometimes I didn't even know what to say, so I'd refer to something that had been spoken in the message at church. Oh yeah, that was good. And then it just died right back down to things of the world. And this went on for weeks and weeks. And finally, one day, I said, well, so Luann, she was Philip's girlfriend at the time. She said, she cracked a joke. And the Spirit of God just came out of my heart real easy. Not even a rebuke, but the Spirit of God was in it. And the Spirit of God will cut. And I said, I will be so glad when I hear the gospel come out of your hearts. I was talking to all of them. The gospel come out of your hearts as often as I hear joking. Well, that put a sword in with my family that day. It put the sword in. And I told every one of them, I said, I want to mind the things of the Spirit. And I'm not going to go to lunch with you anymore. If all you want to talk about is the world, that is not how I want to spend my time. And I told every one of them, every one of the kids, I told Steve, I told them that. Well, there started coming a change with my children, with my family, and I began to overcome the spirits in every one of them and bring them in to flowing with me in the spirit and not just resisting me. It took a while. We're not still completely there. I mean, I'm still overcoming. We've got about 5 minutes left, so I need to wrap up.
You were separating yourself from their flesh.
That's right.
That's all.
It was a separation in the spirit from the things of the flesh.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
I walked it out one day at a time, so that was the song I was going to sing today.
Well, amen. That's good. I have nothing to say. I've heard most of this. I appreciate your commitment to the Lord, to walk with Him, and to do His will. Now, in the past year, God has brought forth some great songs, anointed songs, for Terry to minister, and I appreciate God's grace and mercy on her life and mine and yours. Now she's going to do one of my very favorite songs. I heard verse in 1974, One Day at a Time. Terry.
I'm only human. I'm just a woman. Help me believe in what I can be and all that I am. Show me the stairway I have to climb. one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Give me the strength to do everything that you have me do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Do you remember when you walked among Jesus, you know when you're looking below, it's worse now than then. Cheating and stealing, violence and crime. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day. Do every day what you have me do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Lord, help me today, show me your way, one day at a time.
Send us a and honor and power.
Welcome to Songs of Praise with Terry and the Browns. Hi, I'm Terry, and the Browns are my family. I have four children and a daughter-in-law, and together we worship God. What we do is described by Jesus in the book of John, chapter 4. Jesus said, "The hour cometh and now is, where the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth." Now, we're coming to you today from Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas. And all of us here at Water of Life, the singers and the preachers, everyone, what we preach is the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. I want to read this to you right now, what the gospel is. I encourage you to take this and look at it for yourself. Put your eyes on it. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 1 through 4. "Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I preached unto you, which you also you have received, and wherein you stand, by which also you are saved, if you keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless you've believed in vain. For I delivered unto you first of all, that which I also received." Okay, right here he's going to tell us this gospel. Verse 3, "How that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the scriptures." That's what the gospel is. That's what you are saved by, and that's what you stand in every day of your life once you receive Jesus. And Romans 1:16 tells us, "I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. For therein, in the gospel, is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith. As it is written, the just shall live by faith. by faith. So this verse 16, he's saying, I'm not ashamed. That means I'm not afraid to trust in the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation. Salvation means to be made sound, to be set at safety, to be brought out from every hindering influence. You see, it is so much more than just being born again and going to heaven. It's walking by faith, going from faith to faith. The just live by faith, trusting in, relying on the gospel, relying on Jesus died, was buried, and rose again the third day. That is the power that will work in you every day. Some of you may have heard the previous half hour where I was sharing with on Doyle Davidson's program, and I was sharing about overcoming the flesh and learning to walk in the Spirit. I was sharing some testimonies about that. Well, the way that is accomplished, you find that Romans 8, verses 5, 6, 7, 8, all in there. The way that I accomplished that was by believing the gospel, believing that gospel and taking up my cross every day and walking in it, trusting the power of God every day. And it is the gospel in our hearts. As the music ministers here at Water of Life, we minister the power of God to you. We minister faith. We mix our faith with the gospel to minister the power of God to you. I want to show you in Psalm 22 about praises and what some things about it. Since that's what my program is about, songs of praise, I want to show you this. Look with me in Psalm 22. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? Does that sound familiar? This is Jesus on the cross. So here's what Jesus did when he was on the cross. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? Our sin was laid on him, and it cut him off from the Father. Why art thou so far from helping me and from the words of my roaring? Look what he did when he was cut off from the Father. Oh, my God, I cry in the daytime, but thou hearest not, and in the night season, and am not silent. But thou art holy, O thou that inhabitest the praises of Israel. You see that? The Father inhabits praise. He inhabited Jesus' praise. Jesus praised the Father. His spirit and his soul was in hell. His body was dead in the tomb, but his spirit and his soul was alive in hell, and he praised the Father, and the Father inhabited his praises, and the third day the Father raised him up from the dead. Let's go on and read just a bit more of this. Verse 4, our fathers trusted in thee, they trusted, and thou didst deliver them. They cried to thee and were delivered. They trusted in thee and were not confounded. But I am a worm and no man, a reproach of men, despised of the people. All they that see me left me to scorn. They shoot out the lip, they shake the head, saying, he trusted on the Lord that he would deliver him. Let him deliver him, seeing he delighted in him. Do you remember the scoffers? Have you read that around the foot of the cross? Saying, Jesus, if thou be the Son of God, bring yourself down. You see, this is all prophesied right here in Psalm 22, verse 9. Jesus crying out to the Father, but thou art he that took me out of the womb. Thou didst make me hope when I was upon my mother's breast. I was cast upon thee from the womb. Thou art my God from my mother's belly. Be not thou far from me, for trouble is near, for there is none to help. Many bulls have compassed me. Strong bulls of Bashan have beset me round. They gaped upon me with their mouths as a ravening and a roaring lion. I am poured out like water. Now remember, this is a picture of Jesus on the cross. All my bones are out of joint. My heart is like wax. It is melted in the midst of my bowels. My strength is dried up like a potsherd, and my tongue cleaveth to my jaws. Thus brought me into the dust of death. For dogs have compassed me, the assembly of the wicked have enclosed me. They pierced my hands and my feet. I may tell, that word is count, I may count all my bones. They look and stare upon me. They part my garments among them and cast lots upon my vesture. But be not thou far from me, O Lord, O my strength, haste thee to help me. Deliver my soul from the sword, my darling, from the power of the dog. Save me from the lion's mouth, for thou hast heard me from the horns of the unicorn. Here's the resurrection right here. I will declare thy name unto my brethren. In the midst of the congregation will I praise thee. Ye that fear the Lord, praise him. All ye the seed of Jacob, glorify him. Fear him, all ye the seed of Israel. For he hath not despised nor abhorred the affliction of the afflicted. Neither hath he hid his face from him. But when he cried to him, he heard. My praise shall be of thee in the great congregation. I will pay my vows before them that fear him. Verse 26, the meek shall eat and be satisfied. They shall praise the Lord that seek him. Your heart shall live forever. Do you see that? They shall praise the Lord that seek him. If you want to seek the Lord, you will praise him. If you're wondering, how do I seek the Lord? Praise him. Believe Jesus died and was buried and rose again the third day for you. Believe he had all his bones out of joint for you. And believe that the Father raised him up the third day. In verse 22, when he says, I will declare thy name unto my brethren, in the midst of the congregation will I praise thee. It is Jesus in us that praises the Father. And when you praise the Father, he inhabits your praises. If you are seeking him, you'll be praising him. And one more psalm I want to read to you, and then we're going to get to our music today. Psalm 106. I'm going to only read the last couple of verses. Verse 47. Save us, O Lord our God, and gather us from among the heathen. You know what? Every one of us have been heathen until we're born again and our lives start being conformed to the image of Jesus. Save us, O Lord our God, and gather us from among the heathen to give thanks unto thy holy name and to triumph in thy praise. You hear that? We triumph in praise. So as we minister these songs to you today, I want you to keep in mind the gospel. I want you to keep in mind that as you praise the Father, he'll inhabit your praises. You think if the Father inhabits your praises, you won't get what you need? Jesus did. Jesus was in hell, and he needed to get out of that place, and he praised the Father. What situation are you in? Do you need healing? Do you need money? What needs do you have that need to be met? Are you lonely and sad? Are you brokenhearted? Whatever your problem is, it's not worse than being in hell. And Jesus got out of hell by praising the Father. And you receive the Lord Jesus. You receive him as your Lord. You believe on him and be born again. And his spirit is one with your spirit. And he lives in you. And he will take your life up and lead you. And you can triumph in praises. Jesus in you will praise. And you can triumph in every situation too. We've got some music today. I'm going to bring you songs from the various groups of the Brown family. I want to say first off, I'm grateful to the Lord to be on the shortwave channels, all 11 channels of World Harvest Radio around the world, virtually covering the world. It's a great honor upon our lives to be sent forth with the high praises of God in our mouth. So I'm going to introduce the groups of the Browns today. And in future programs, I'll have other ministers of music from Water of Life Church in Plano join me. And the first song we'll start with is brought to us from the Water of Life Quartet. And this quartet is Paul Peters, one of the young men here in the ministry, another minister of music, joining with my three sons, Philip, David, and Daniel Brown. They are the Water of Life Quartet, and they're going to minister Washed in the Blood. Next, I'll do a solo for you called What the Cross is For. Following that, we'll have a trio called the Brown Brothers, which happens to be my three boys. they're going to do, somebody touched me. And then following that, we will have Paul Peters joining me, my boys, my daughter Jenny, my daughter-in-law Luann, and we will all do for you at Calvary. So that's our music lineup today. So let's get on to our songs of praise and worship.
Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in His grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Are you washed in the blood?
In the blood,
in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb.
Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you walking daily by the Savior's side? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Do you rest each moment in the crucified? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Are you washed in the blood?
In the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Lay aside the garments that are stained with sin and be washed in the blood of the Lamb. There's a fountain flowing for the soul unclean. Oh, be washed in the blood of the Lamb.
Are you washed in the blood?
In the blood, in the soul. Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? When the bridegroom cometh, will your robes be white and be washed in the blood of the Lamb? Will your soul be ready for the mansions bright and be washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Are you washed in the blood?
Cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Are you washed in the blood?
In the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Oh, be washed in the blood of the Lamb.
Your mind confused and cluttered. Life has your back against the wall. Mercy's been there in the shadows. Your heart won't let him in at all. There's a cross of pain where Jesus bore the burden of your sin. A place where dying deep inside, new life wells up again. He wants to ease your pain. Eternal life you'll gain. He's standing by your door. That's what the cross is for. Oh, my friend, I've been where you are, lost in that cold and lonely place. Is filled with such despair. pain is etched upon your face. Listen to the answer. Is the cross you'll find Jesus there? It's true. Oh, I too was lost. I've been set free. He'll do the same for you. He wants to ease your pain. Eternal life you'll gain. He's standing by your door. That's what the cross is for. Thank you, Lord. Praise you. Praise you, Father. We worship you. We praise you, Holy Spirit. I bless you, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Father. Bless you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Jesus will ease your pain. Eternal life you'll gain. He's standing by your door. That's what the cross is for. Your heart he will restore. That's what the cross is for. That's what the cross.
Many years he walked in darkness as he groped along the streets. His hand stretched out for pennies or for just a bite to eat. It's the story of the blind man when Jesus walked his way and with the master's touch the man looked up. As the scoffers heard him say, somebody touch me, somebody touch me. I was blind, but praise his name, I now can see. I was in darkness when Jesus found me. But since he touched me, I now am free. One day he touched the crippled man, and today he walks again. And now the master saw with pleasure he had labored not in vain. Like the story of the blind man, I once was bound by sin, but since the master came, oh praise his name, thank God I now can say, somebody touch me, somebody touch me. I was blind, but praise his name, I now can see. I was in darkness when Jesus found me, but since he touched me, I now am free. Somebody touched me, somebody touched me. I was blind, but praise his name, I now can see. I was in darkness when Jesus found me, but since he touched me, I now am free. I was in darkness when Jesus found me, but since he touched me, thank God I'm free. Thank God I'm free.
salvation's plan. Oh, the grace that brought it down to man. Oh, the mighty gulf that God did span at Calvary. Mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied.
Mercy and the grace of God demonstrated to us, to you and to me, through the cross of Jesus. Jesus on the cross, dying and being buried and being raised again. If you've never received Him as your Savior, you must be born again to know the salvation of God, to know His mercy and grace in your life every day and throughout eternity. Romans 10 tells us, that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God hath raised Him from the dead, you shall be saved. You shall be saved. You can be born again. That is the power for you to be saved every day in every situation. Thanks for joining me today. I hope to see you next time. God bless you.
We invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas, 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.